There's no denying that Pinoy's experience some of the worst driving conditions compared to anywhere in the world. Daily, we deal with unbelievably bad traffic and inconsiderate drivers and riders, not to mention pothole-ridden roads which can rival the moon. You add all that up, and that's a recipe for a road accident almost at every turn. Thankfully, car manufacturers are using technology to make our cars safer to drive. Take, for example, Subaru with its EyeSight technology. It uses cameras to detect oncoming vehicles so it can warn the driver ahead of time. It's been available in other countries for the past few years, but it's only being introduced in 2018 XV and a few other models locally. When we asked Subaru why it took so long to bring the EyeSight technology here, they said it took extra time to make sure the technology worked considering our unique road conditions. That's a good call, I'd say. But the question now is, have they succeeded? Let's find out.
Hey guys, you're watching Rev, your ultimate guide to choosing your next ride. For this week, we are taking this crossover for a spin. This is the all-new Subaru XV 2.0 IS CVT with EyeSight. Now, aside from its basic shape and the fact that it's a crossover, it has very little to do with its predecessor. Now, that's not a bad thing because now it's sharper, sleeker, and it's got a proper sporty and modern vibe to it. Now, lately, Subaru has been churning out much more attractive vehicles when it comes to its newer models, and this XV is a prime example of that. Let's start by talking about what you see on the outside. Take a look at these slim and sleek C-shaped LED headlights. And under that, you've got these angular fog lamp housings. Over here, you've got a much sleeker and sportier hexagonal front grille done up in black with just a touch of chrome in the right place. It's got a two-tone paint job. This is cool gray khaki, color that I love. The lower front and rear fenders are done up in matte black. And over on the side, you'll see that Subaru has also gone two-tone with the rims. It's black with brushed alloy. Now, you can't miss the fact that from the factory to the showroom, it already comes standard with roof rails, which give away the fact that this vehicle is oriented for adventure travel. Now, over in the back, the taillights literally get a big makeover because they are much larger now, which give the vehicle a much more aggressive presence. Overall, it's a step in the right direction for Subaru, if you ask me. Now, I wouldn't describe the vehicle as rugged, but it does have good ground clearance, which does say something about its go-anywhere attitude. And the fact that it's a lot sportier and sharper now is a real nod to Subaru's rally heritage. Now over on the inside, well, it's more of the same. Subaru has taken great strides in making sure that this model is a definite upgrade over the previous model's interiors. Let's talk about the upholstery. It's predominantly black leather for the seats and armrests. It's not the softest of leathers, but it is quite nice, especially with this orange contrast stitching to break up the black. Now you've got some carbon fiber effect finishes happening over here towards the door and these metallic accents as well. Now I want to point out that these are just metallic, they're not actual metal. It's plastic finished in a metallic finish, but it's actually quite tasteful and it doesn't look cheesy or cheap. Now the steering wheel is a nice classic shape, some nice leather wrap on it, again with a contrast stitching, nice contour, nicely shaped. Now, some other finishes that you'll find in here is some piano black towards the shifter. It's a nice finish which sort of breaks up the texture, but you will want to be careful with this because this kind of finish is actually quite prone to scratching. Now the seats, very comfortable, very supportive, particularly towards the lumbar area. Lots of leg room, lots of headroom. Not the most headroom I've seen, but there's ample space. Over in the back, you've also got good space for three adults, and you've also got usable boot space. Now, this is a hatch, so you can fold down those back seats and take advantage of the extra room. Now, the XV is also equipped with a multi-function display. It'll give you information like your current speed, gearing, oil temperature, water temperature, even the ambient temperature. You'll also have some details on how your eyesight system is working. So overall, there's a lot of good driver information that you have access to. Now, we rarely gush about infotainment systems, but this car has a particularly good one. This 8-inch infotainment system is a gem. Now, not only is it your typical touchscreen, but it also has some physical buttons on there, which allows for a much more sort of tactile experience as you toggle through the various functions. Now, the sound system in this car, excellent. The sound quality coming from these speakers is really good. Nice deep bass, and the highs come in really clearly as well. It'll certainly make long drives much more of a pleasure with an infotainment system like this. Now, speaking of long drives, I think it's about time that we take this baby out. All right, we are rolling out in the all-new Subaru XV. This variant is the 2.0 IS. That means it's equipped with the eyesight system from Subaru. Now, I am really excited to show you guys what that system can do. But first, let's talk about a few initial impressions of the car. Now, we're putting in some very easy sort of city miles now. And so far, the car feels great. The previous model XV was known to be a relatively quiet cabin. And the new XV is really pretty much more of the same, only a step up. It feels like you're very well insulated from the noise and hullabaloo that's going on outside. So it's a nice sort of private little world that you're in once you're inside the car. Suspension feel so far, we're driving on typical Manila roads, which like I said, has the usual bumps and potholes here and there. The suspension has handled it very well. It feels very comfortable. It's not overly plush where you feel sort of detached from what's going on underneath the car, and it doesn't have too much roll and sway, which has a tendency to get some drivers and passengers dizzy if they're easily car sick. So it's a nice sort of middle ground in terms of suspension feel. The car is a CVT, shifts from one gear ratio to the next is actually quite seamless. You don't feel that jerk or nudge when the car is jumping from one gear to the next. Well, technically a CVT doesn't have gears. So it's very, very smooth. Steering is quite nice, very responsive as you maneuver the car through typical traffic conditions that we have here in Manila. It's not the lightest of touches or lightest of feels. It's again also a nice sort of middle ground. It gives you good feedback as to you know, how you're maneuvering and controlling the car. It's not overly soft, but it's not by any means tiring or overly firm to use. The contours of a steering wheel are actually quite nice. It's a nice round steering wheel, traditional, which I prefer. Nicely contoured, nice to grip. And the controls are well thought out. All the buttons are actually within easy reach. The paddles are on the smaller side, but you will easily find them if your hands are on the traditional 3, 9, or 10, 2 position. There's a lot of usable space in terms of storage, lots of room for your phone, other devices, other gadgets, good storage, and very well sort of thought out and positioned instruments. All in all, quite a nice car to drive. Yeah, Hey guys, welcome back to Rev. Now, we'll get back to our review of the Subaru XV a little bit later on in the program. For now, it's on to the news.
You can now drive our very own Angie King's 2017 Ferrari Challenge race car from the comfort of your couch. The version 1.5 update of Project Cars 2 included cars from the 2017 Ferrari Challenge series. Angie King was one of the racers in the Asia-Pacific leg of the race series, and her uniquely designed number 12 purple-colored Ferrari Challenge race car, complete with the Philippine flag, can now turn heads on the racetrack in the virtual racing world. The update was first rolled out for the PC version of Project Cars 2, and the console version is set to come out soon. Looks like Volkswagen will give the car-crazy Philippine market a lot to look forward to this 2018. Volkswagen Philippines aims to bring back the essence of the people's car as it unveiled its 2018 model lineup with very competitive pricing and for the Philippine market.
I'm happy to say that the Philippines is one of those countries that was picked by Volkswagen in order to further this change in the market. And we are blessed to start that here as the first country. It is built on all the both advanced technologies, the best materials, the most engineering and R&D that has been done in order to make sure that the experience will be first rate. And to further bring it down to its core, where is, we believe, bringing it back to the people.
Volkswagen's lineup is highlighted by the Santana, which starts at just 686,000 pesos. It's equipped with a 1.4-liter engine which produces 90 horsepower and 132 newton-meters of torque. It's the embodiment of German engineering for the budget-friendly subcompact segment. Volkswagen also released the Volkswagen LaVita to strengthen its hold on the compact car segment. The LaVita is powered by a 1.4-liter turbocharged engine which produces 130 horsepower and 225 newton-meters of torque. It comes with a 7-speed DSG transmission, and it promises to provide adequate power and fuel economy. Volkswagen also brought the best-selling SUV in China in the all-new Tiguan. The Tiguan is equipped with Volkswagen's patented safety tech and a 1.4-liter engine which puts out 150 horses and 250 newton-meters of torque. Come November, the much-awaited subcompact station wagon Santana GTS and the premium compact Volkswagen LaMondo are set to arrive on Philippine shores.
And that's it for the news. Now it's time to flex our muscles the car enthusiast way. I'm talking about Mansky, of course, and this week's DIY project.
Thank you, Paolo. Picture this. Your steed is like Liam Hemsworth. Good-looking, robust, and sexy. Thing is, he's got hepatitis yellow eyes. In your car's case, it's oxidized yellowish headlights. What a turnoff. No matter how good the rest of your ride may seem, if your headlights look dull and lost its clarity, your car can look ugly, old, and affect your range of vision when you're driving at night. Now, before you decide to buy a pair of expensive headlights, let's try and do some DIY hacks. Of course, some of you might have heard of the white toothpaste method on YouTube videos, but you know what? This stuff never really lasts, so let's junk it. The reason why we're using masking tape all around the headlights is to protect the paintwork so that we don't damage it while we are working on the headlights. While you're doing this, you can talk to your car so your car doesn't get bored. Hey baby, how you doing today? Let me take out your cataracts for you, okay? So you can see better. We're gonna look better together. For our first approach, we're gonna be doing a wet sanding method, and you're gonna need 2000 grit sandpaper, a spray bottle filled with water, a terry towel, and a finishing compound to remove all that micro marring from sanding. Of course, we got masking tape right here. As you saw earlier, we covered the outline of the headlight to protect your paintwork. Let's get to it. You begin by spraying the surface of the headlamp, like so, and then begin sanding in a circular motion, like so. Of course, just relax. Huwag kang gigil, in other words. Keep spraying, never let it dry out. The whole idea behind this is lessening the abrasiveness of this approach while removing the oxidized plastic from the headlamps. Never forget to inspect your work from time to time. So wipe it down and take a look. It's looking much clearer from here, guys. I'm liking what I see. For the last step in this process, we're gonna finish the job with a fine compound. Basically, the purpose for this is to take away all those tiny scratches the sanding has made on the surface of your headlamp. Just get a little bit of this compound onto the terry towel, like so. Rub in a circular fashion. You could even increase your speed, so use some elbow grease. This is a good workout, by the way, guys. We're buffing this off with a dry terry towel, and your masking tape's actually coming off, but that's okay, because we're about done, and it's looking much better than it was 20 minutes ago. Ta-da! So guys, this is our last approach for headlight restoration, and we're gonna be using a surface refinisher. This is a chemical process on restoring your headlights, and it's super easy, and I'm gonna show you guys how it's done right now. If you take a closer look, you can see the chemicals beginning to do their magic on the surface, and give it a couple of minutes, all you gotta do is just rub it off with a dry terry towel. So now I'm doing the Van Damme split to get into position. As we are about to buff this chemical stuff away from the headlight surface. So here we go. Apply moderate pressure using the palm of your hand as you rub it in a circular fashion. So I'm gonna use the secondary towel, the dry towel, to wipe things off and see how our work turned out. The nice thing about this surface refinisher, it's not harmful to your paint. It actually cleans out your paint. A job well done, I'd say. Job well done. Revitalizing your headlamps will have an overall impact on the beauty of your car. Plus, you'll see better at night. We'd like to thank Technical Details for supporting us today. There you go. This has been Mansky for Keep It Clean. Shaka.
Thanks, Mansky. Now, aside from the obvious changes that Subaru has made to the XV, the biggest news for us, here in the Philippines anyway, is eyesight. Now, in a nutshell, eyesight is an extra set of eyes on the road, which helps keep the driver safer when he's behind the wheel. And it does this through two cameras located on either side of the rear view mirror. Now, this technology has actually been around for quite a while. In fact, ANC was first invited to Japan almost 3 years ago to try it out for ourselves. And guess what? It works just as advertised. It has taken Subaru quite a while to make it available locally though, and that's perfectly understandable considering how crazy our streets work. Now, the real standout of the eyesight system is its adaptive cruise control. Unlike traditional cruise controls where you basically set a cruising speed and the car maintains that speed until you disengage it, the eyesight system is a whole lot smarter. So in this case, I've got it set at a nice sort of middle ground, 80 kilometers per hour as we're on the highway. And what the system does is it basically takes a look at the vehicle in front of you via these two cameras that are mounted in front. And it's basically nominating that as the lead vehicle. Now, what it does is it maintains the ideal distance between your car and the car in front of you. In this case, it's set at a minimum of one car length. So right now, I'm not stepping on the gas. I'm not stepping on the brakes. If the vehicle in front of us slows down, the system slows down the car as well. If the gap opens up, then the system adds some speed, maintaining a maximum of 80 kilometers per hour, which is our cruising speed. It's an amazing system that works really well. Now, I do want to mention that Subaru has designed the system for highway driving. But for purposes, of course, of this demo, we're driving along EDSA and the system actually works. It takes a little bit of trust to fully appreciate the system. But once you get a feel for it, it's actually quite good and it's really amazing how this technology works. So again, I'm not touching the accelerator or the brakes. The car is just basically maintaining a set distance between the car and the vehicle in front. Amazing stuff. So once it comes to a complete stop, you will have to nudge it forward. There you go. It gives you a little bit of a warning saying that the vehicle in front of you has started moving. So you have to give the accelerator a little bit of a nudge so that the car gets going again. But basically, it just maintains that set distance. I do want to mention, though, that if you are driving on crowded streets and using the system, it will maintain quite a large gap, in this case, about a car's length, which will encourage other cars to sort of weave in into your lane, which, you know, this is how things are done here in Manila. But then again, like I said, the system isn't really designed for bumper-to-bumper traffic like we're experiencing now in rush hour EDSA. But just for purposes of the demonstration, it actually does work in conditions like this. So again, we've got the warning, vehicle ahead has moved. You give the accelerator a bit of a nudge, and the car moves forward.
The EyeSight system also includes pre-collision braking. What it basically does is it warns the driver if an obstacle is in front of the vehicle. But if the driver fails to act on it, the car will automatically brake to lessen the impact or avoid the accident altogether. And the last feature is what Subaru calls pre-collision throttle management. This controls the power of the engine when the situation for it arises, like when a vehicle is in front of you and suddenly stops right when you are accelerating. The system will recognize that and reduce power from the engine.
All right, after testing the EyeSight system, I am totally blown away. It's an amazing system that works amazingly well. We do want to point out, though, that it's not meant to be an autonomous driving experience. You do have to steer the car, and you do have to watch what's going on in front of you, but it does add an extra layer of safety, particularly for drivers who are prone to being distracted. Now, I did want to turn that off and give you guys a few impressions of highway driving on the XV. Now, it feels really good. The suspension feels really good on good surfaces like this when the road opens up. So we're switching into manual now and rowing through the gears. It is a CVT. It doesn't give you the satisfaction that a full manual would give you. It's very smooth, and that's the real strength of the CVT. So it doesn't have that... It doesn't sort of allow you to sort of dip into those higher revs very easily because it is very smooth. So it doesn't have that sense of satisfaction that a full manual gives you, but it makes up for it in smoothness, all right? So you have the option, of course, to drive in full automatic or shift manually, but know that a CVT doesn't have that sense of urgency that a full manual does. But otherwise, it's a very smooth drive. All right, now the Subaru XV, it's a 2-liter boxer engine. It does give you 154 horsepower, 196 newton meters of torque. So it's ample. It's got enough grunt to it. And it feels quite good. It feels quite good on the highway. Steering is very stable. The car does feel very stable. It is a Subaru, so it is all-wheel drive. So the car does feel very sure-footed. Like I mentioned earlier, the suspension is fantastic. The suspension feels really good. It's a nice balance between being plush and being able to sort of hug the road. Now, we've had a chance to drive the XV in city conditions, a little bit of highway driving, and now some more sort of open roads. We've had a variety of surfaces from nice sort of asphalt blacktop to a little bit more bumpier concrete here. One thing that I do want to point out is the strengths of the XV are becoming more apparent. The cabin noise, or the insulation actually from noise, is actually really good, and that really comes to the fore. But one thing that I do want to underline is the suspension. The suspension is really good. I don't know if it's the combination maybe of the all-wheel drive and the correct spring rate and damping rates, but Subaru has done something really good with the suspension. It gives you a nice, even ride. It's sort of a nice middle ground between sort of being able to hug the road and provide a little bit of comfort and plushness. But it's sort of, it's hit a nice sweet spot. Good job, Subaru.
Now let's think about what Subaru has done with the new XV. They've practically improved on every major category you can think of. The exterior looks properly sporty with practicality to boot. The interior has been upgraded to feel more premium and upscale. Drivability has been improved across the board. And with Subaru's EyeSight technology, that just brings the XV over and above what you would expect from a crossover in this class.